It's like if you show up 20 minutes early to a party, you're not a loser. You're smart. Because they usually have the food out. They have the food out and they're still doing the setup. So you can get involved. You go, no, you carry on. Don't worry about me. You look at that time, you go, guacamole looks good. I'm going to give it a go. It's going to try it for her. Give her some valuable feedback if she needs it. So you grab a chip. No, you're not a fool. You know to go and slow, right? Like, you've been around food before, you know. Don't worry. When that chip breaks, you're so disappointed in yourself. You're like, how am I this age and I can't nail a snack? Because now you know you're in deep shit. You better get that chip out before she comes out. I'll fuck up the table before anyone else gets there. You're going to take another chip. But you're going to take a strong one, you know, the... No, because you know the ones that are curved, the curved ones on them, so they're structurally stronger than the other. So you take that curve. Also, pro tip, they always have more flavour because they just sort of... Anyway, so... So you take that chip. Now, you know you're not a fool. You're going to go low and slow. You're going to go low and slow, and you want to slowly curve it around the original chip. Like, just make a little... You don't want to go too close because then it could structurally damage that. So you just want to go... When that second chip breaks... You question every decision you've ever made as an adult. You're like, I should probably not be alone. Because now you know you better get that out before she comes out. You've got two chips in there. You're not going to take another chip. You're not an idiot. You're going to learn from your mistakes here. You don't want her to come out to two half-dead chips in the guacamole with a fucking moat around it. When your second knuckle in, she comes out and busts you. Like you're at your high school dance. You just lock eyes with it. I love that slow realization. Ooh. My hand's still in the guacamole. She walks out, she locks eyes with you. She looks at you, you look at her. She knows your hand's in the guacamole. You know your hand's in the guacamole. He just look at her, because you don't know at what point should you pull your hand out. There's no time like the present, so you just pull it out. Now the bigger conundrum, do you flick it or lick it? She just says that you're never breaking eye contact, looking after you, just taking the bogey. I wasn't that happy with it anyway. She walks in the kitchen, you can throw it in the sink. You feel like such a loser because you go, it's out of season for avos. That would have cost her $400. You're not a loser, but what you didn't realise that if you normally show up 20 minutes late, the guacamole has been sitting on the table for 40 minutes, slowly getting to room temperature, and then it smooths anything. You can fucking lift it with anything out of that bowl. You can lift it with hopes and dreams into your mouth. You don't know that because you're not a chef. Neither am I, but I'm an enthusiast.